الله رب العالمين صلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. إن شاء الله we're going to continue benefiting from the commentary of الشيخ صالح بن فوزان الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى on this very valuable book, very precious book in the belief system, which is a book that every Muslim and Muslimah must have in their library. And every Muslim and Muslimah must study this book chapter by chapter and try to understand it with the explanation of our senior scholars. Like there is, alhamdulillah, you can find two volumes of this book explained by Sheikh Salih bin Fawzan al-Fawzan, hafidhahullah ta'ala, which is, it's called Sharh al-Sunnah, the explanation of the creed, the explanation of the creed by Imam al-Barbahari. So you find the commentary of Sheikh Salih bin Fawzan al-Fawzan. And this one is the Arabic, the original. This one is the original of this book explained by الشيخ صالح بن فوزان الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى. قال المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى وعلم بأن الدنيا دار إيمان وإسلام. The author رحمه الله الإمام البربهاري, he said no, that this world is dunya, this world is the land of Iman and the land of Iman and Islam. It is the land of Iman. Daru Iman wa Daru Islam is the land of Iman and Islam. Wa ummatu Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fiha mu'minun muslimun fi ahkamihim wa mawaritihim wa dabaihihim wa salati alayhim. He said rahimahullah ta'ala that the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the community of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, amongst them, there are believers, Muslim believers and Muslims in terms of their rulings. Like we judge them to be believers and Muslims. And also they get to inherit from each other. And also we eat the meat that they slaughter. They eat it, we eat the meat of the Muslim. And also if they die, we perform janazah on them. We perform salat al-janazah, janazah prayer on them. He said, وَلَا نَشْهَدُ لِأَحَدٍ بِحَقِيقَةِ الْإِيمَانِ حَتَّى يَأْتِي بِجَمِيعِ شَرَائِعِ الْإِسْلَامِ. He said, and we don't witness for anyone to have a complete reality of Iman until he fulfilled all the legislation of Islam. Until he fulfills all the legislations of Islam and the legislations from it. So the affair of al-i'tiqad. It's from the deen also. So the testimony that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. And this is the foundation of the deen. Then after that, the person fulfills the other legislation, salat, zakat, fasting the month of Ramadan, performing hajj, and so on and so forth. فَإِنْ قَصَّرَ فِي شَيْءٍ مِّنْ ذَلِكَ كَانَ نَاقِصُ الْإِيمَانِ حَتَّى يَتُوبُ. He said, if the person falls short in any of those legislation, then he will be deficient in his iman. He will be deficient in his belief until he makes tawbah. He makes توبة. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ إِيمَانَهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى أَنَّ إِيمَانَهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى تَامَّ الْإِيمَانِ أَوْ نَاقِسَ الْإِيمَانِ إِلَّا مَا أَظْهَرَ لَكَ مِنْ تَضِيعِ شَرَائِعِ الْإِسْلَامِ. He said, as far as his iman is concerned, that is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whether that person has a complete iman or he is deficient in iman. except what he manifests. For example, if someone manifests that he does not give zakat, then he has to be rebuked. He has to be reprimanded and rebuked, because this is the deficiency in his iman. If he's lazy and he does not give the poor do zakat or the like, even though he has money, this is haram. And this is the deficiency in his iman, because he's not fulfilling one of the legislation of al-Islam. Now the commentary of Sheikh Saleh al-Fawzan, he said, قَوْلُهُ وَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ الدُّنْيَا دَارُ إِيمَانٍ وَإِسْلَامٍ يعني أن الإسلام والإيمان في الدنيا التي هي دار العمل أما الآخرة فإنها دار الجزاء. So the statement of the author, رحمه الله تعالى, Sheikh Saleh al-Fawzan, he said that al-Islam wal-Iman in this world, which is a world of actions, good deeds. As for the next world, it is not a world of action, it is a world of recompense. So you get rewarded according to what you have done in the life of this world. فالإسلام والإيمان إنما يكونان في الدنيا أما من مات على غير الإسلام والإيمان فإنه كافر. Sheikh said, as for Islam wal Iman, they are in this dunya. So the person has to believe here and the like. So he has to do good deeds and the like. But if the person dies upon kufr, if he dies upon kufr, وَالْعِيَدُ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا يَنْفَعُ أَنَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, he said on the day of judgment, he will not benefit if he says, well, I believe now, because it's too late. So he has to believe in this world. إذا شاهد من كفر به يؤمن أن يتمنى الرجوع ويطلب من ربه أنه يرجع لأجل أن يؤمن. He said the disbeliever on the day of judgment, he regrets. And he requests from his Lord to go back to the life of this world so that he can rectify his affair. So that he can rectify. As Allah said in the Quran, وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذْ وُقِفُوا عَلَى النَّارِ فَقَالُوا يَا لَيْتَنَا نُرَدُّ وَلَا نُكَذِّبُ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّنَا وَنَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. In Surah Al-An'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarified this reality. He said, if you could but see when they would stand upon the fire, like upon the brink of the fire, at that time they would say, we wish to go back to the life of this world so that we would not reject the signs of our Lord. Means the Quran and also the message that was sent to them and the like. And we wish that we are from the believers. We are from the believers. والإسلام والإيمان بينهما فرق. Sheikh Saleh al-Fawzan, he said, الإسلام والإيمان, there is difference between them. بينهما فرق. There is difference between them. لأن الدين ثلاث مراتب. Because the religion of Islam is based upon three levels. So, أولاً, the first level, الإسلام. The first level, الإسلام. And the second level, الإيمان, belief. والثالث, الإحسان. So now we have الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان. Three levels. كما في حديث جبريل. As it is in the hadith of جبريل. وأوسعها الإسلام. And the most comprehensive is Islam. The most comprehensive is الإسلام. لأن الإسلام والاستسلام في الظاهر. Because الإسلام is when you submit outwardly. When you submit outwardly. وَقَدْ يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنًا فِي الْبَاطِنِ وَقَدْ يَكُونُ مُنَافِقًا. So this person who submit outwardly, he may be a believer in his heart, or he may be a hypocrite. He may be a hypocrite. كَافِرْ فِي الْبَاطِنِ. So he might be a hypocrite who manifests al-Iman And he manifested Islam wal Iman outwardly, but he hides kufr in his heart. أَمَّا الْإِيمَانِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُطْلَقُ عَلَى الْمُنَافِقِ. As for al-Iman, we do not use it for the hypocrite. Because the hypocrite, he manifests. He said, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ. This is Islam. So even he entered Islam with his tongue, but we don't say that this person is a believer if we know he is a hypocrite. Because the hypocrite is a disbeliever in reality. فَإِنَّهُ يَدْخُلُ فِي الْمُؤْمِنِ كَامِلُ الْإِيمَانِ يَدْخُلُ فِيهِ الْمُؤْمِنِ نَاقِسَ الْإِيمَانِ. He said, as for الإيمان, he said, there are Muslims who have complete Iman. And there are those who have deficient Iman. They have deficient Iman. فَإِذَا ذُكِرَ الْإِسْلَامُ وَالْإِيمَانُ جَمِيعًا فَإِنَّهُ يُرَادُ بِالْإِسْلَامِ الْأَحْكَامِ الظَّاهِرَةِ. Now the Sheikh, he said, if al-Islam wal-Iman, they were mentioned together in one sentence, Islam wal-Iman, then al-Islam is the outward actions. What are the outward actions? Salat. طيب, zakat, hajj, these are outward actions. طيب. He said, وَيُرَادُ بِالْإِيمَانِ الْأَحْكَامِ الْبَاطِنَةِ. And the iman are the rulings that have to do with the heart. They have to do with the heart. كَمَا فِي حَدِيثِ جِبْرِيل. As it is in the hadith of Jibreel. الْإِسْلَامُ أَنْ تَشْهَدَ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَتُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَتُؤْتِي الزَّكَاةِ وَتَصُومَ رَمَضَانَ وَتَحُجَّ الْبَيْتِ. طيب. Al-Islam, as it is in Hadith of Jibreel, Al-Islam is to bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is his messenger, and you establish the Salat, and you give the Zakat, and you fast the month of Ramadan, and you perform Hajj. He said these are a'mal dahira. These are outward actions. قال أخبرني عن الإيمان. He said, tell me about Iman. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسوله واليوم الآخر وأن تؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. هذه أعمال باطنة. So he said, الإيمان is to believe in Allah. Believing in Allah has to do with the heart, right? Has to do with the heart. طيب. To believe in Allah, to believe in His angels, to believe in His books, to believe in His messengers, to believe in the last day, and to believe in Al-Qadr, preordainment, good or bad. Sheikh said, these are outward, these are inward actions. Has to do with the affair of the heart. وَلَا بُدَّ مِنْ اجْتِمَاعِ الْإِسْلَامُ وَالْإِيمَانِ فَإِذَا ذُكِرَ وَاحِدْ فَقَطْ دَخَلَ فِيهِ الْآخَرِ دخل فيه الآخر. إذا ذكر الإيمان وحده دخل فيه الإسلام. Now, when they are separated, means they're not mentioned together. الإسلام is mentioned separately and الإيمان is mentioned separately. Then one will enter into the other. For example, when الإسلام is mentioned without الإيمان, الإيمان enters into الإسلام. When الإيمان is mentioned by itself, الإسلام enters into الإيمان. You understand? But when they are mentioned together, they separate in their meaning. Is it understood? طيب. The Sheikh, he said, حفظه الله تعالى. نعم. ولهذا يقول الإسلام والإيمان إذا اجتمع افترقا. And that's why they say, when الإيمان والإسلام, they are mentioned together, they separate in their meaning. They separate in their meaning. Meaning that Islam is the outward actions, and the Iman is the inward actions. طيب, Iman are the belief system. طيب, يعني في المعنى وإذا افترق اجتمع. And when they separate, they come together. When they separate, they come together. You understand what do you mean by that? When they separate in them, when they separate, Islam is mentioned without iman. Tayyib, then they're gonna come together now. Are we gonna include iman or not? Yes. And if iman is mentioned by itself, are we gonna conclude Islam or not? We are gonna conclude Islam. Okay, Islam is going to be included. Is going to be included. Tayyib. The Shaykh, he said, يعني في المعنى وإذا افترق الجماعة يعني في المعنى مثل الفقير والمسكين إذا ذكر جميعا صار الفقير له معنى والمسكين له معنى. He said another example is like the word فقير and مسكين. Okay, you have الفقير and you have المسكين. Okay, الفقير, when the word فقير and مسكين are mentioned together, then الفقير has a meaning and the المسكين has a meaning. Got it? So al-faqir will be someone who doesn't have anything. Okay? So he will be more worthy to receive the zakat. Like for example, if you have a choice either to give zakat to a faqir or miskin, which one do you give it to? Al-faqir. Because al-faqir doesn't have anything. Al-miskin he has, but he doesn't have enough. You understand? For example, he may have money to pay the rent, but he doesn't have money to pay the bills and the food. And then other than this one is miskin. Tayyib, miskin. So he's lacking. Tayyib. But the first one, he doesn't have anything. Tayyib. Now, when al-faqir is mentioned by itself, al-miskin enters. When al-miskin is mentioned by itself, al-faqir enters. But when they are mentioned together, they have a different meaning. Is that clear? طيب. Very, very important. Very important. The Shaykh, he said, وَقَوْلُهُ وَمُحَمَّدٌ وَأُمَّةٌ مُحَمَّدٌ صلى الله عليه وسلم فِيهَا مُؤْمِنُونَ مُسْلِمُونَ فِي أَحْكَامِهِمْ وَمَوَارِثِهِمْ وَدَبَائِحِمْ وَالصَّلَاةِ عَلَيْهِمْ. He said, as the statement of the author, rahimahullah, and the community of Muhammad, صلى الله عليه وسلم, there are mu'minun, believers, and muslimuns. There are muslimuns and believers in the community of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in terms of their rulings, and their inheritance, and if they slaughter an animal and the like, and also to perform salat al-janaza on them. الشيخ يسأل أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم مؤمنون لأن من كان مؤمنا فهو مسلم. الشيخ يسأل the أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم they are believers and anyone who is a believer is a Muslim. He's a Muslim. ومن كان مسلما فقد يكون مؤمنا وقد يكون منافقا. But as far as the Muslim is concerned, then he could be a believer, he could be a hypocrite. Because someone says, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَىٰ إِلَىٰ اللَّهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولَ اللَّهُ. Okay, the origin that this person believes in Allah, right or wrong? Unless we have an evidence that says he's not. طيب, if his action contradicts his statement, طيب, he's not a believer. طيب, for example, he worships Jesus. He said, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَىٰ إِلَىٰ اللَّهُ. But he goes to the church and he worships Jesus. Is this a believer? He's not a believer. Even though he said, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, he entered Islam, but he is not a believer. طيب. So some of them may be believers, some of them may not be believers, as the Shaykh mentioned here. لكن الإسلام الصحيح لا بد معه من الإيمان. He said the correct Islam has to have iman with it. Has to have iman with it. نعم. ولو قليلا, even if it's a little. قالت الأعراب آمنا. قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا. In Surah Al-Hujurat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that الأعراب, the Bedouins, they say that we believe. Then Allah said to them, don't say you believe, but say you have entered Islam. You see? So there is a big difference between Islam and Iman. So someone may say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, but we don't know the reality of this man. You understand? Even though we accept his Islam, at Allahu a'lam. Some of the people, they say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, iyadu billah, and they are in reality munafiqeen, wa iyadu billah. They are munafiqeen. قوله في أحكامهم ومواريتهم in the statement of the author that they are Muslims and they are believers in regards to their inheritance. المسلم ولو ظاهرا له حكم المسلمين يتولونه. He said the Muslim, even if he appears outwardly to be a Muslim, then he deserves support from the Muslims. He deserves support from the Muslim. وَإِذَا مَتَى يُغَسِّلُونَهُ وَيُكَفِّنُونَهُ وَيُصَلُّونَ عَلَيْهِ. And if he dies, he has a right upon them to wash him, to shroud him, and to perform salat al-janaza on him. وَيَدْفِنُونَهُ فِي مَقَابِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And he has a right upon them to be buried in the Muslim graveyard. وَعَلَى قَيْدِ الْحَيَاةِ يُحِبُّونَهُ وَيَتَوَلَّوْنَهُ وَيَتَرَحَّمُونَ بَيْنَهُمْ وَيَتَرَحَّمُونَ بَيْنَهُمْ. And while this person is still alive, then they love him, they show him support. نعم. And they show him brotherhood and all that. هذه أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل الجسد الواحد. إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the similitude of the believers in their love and their compassion, in their love, mercy, and compassion. It's like one body. When this body is stricken by a fever, sick, and the body gets a fever, is the fever gonna hit only one area of the body or the whole body? The whole body. Likewise, the ummah is like that. The ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم should be like that. When one of us is hurting, we should all be hurting. When one of us need help, we should all help. This is how we should be. This is the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when there is fever in that body, most likely that person is not gonna sleep. He's not gonna sleep. He's gonna stay awake. Sahar. طيب. And it's not gonna be easy for him. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام المؤمن للمؤمن كالبنيان يشد بعضه بعضا وشبك بين أصابعه. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he did this. He entwined his fingers like that. And he said, the believer is like a wall has bricks, and these bricks, they support one another. That's why you have this wall. So if there were no bricks there, we're not going to have no wall. So these bricks, they support each other. Likewise, the believer with the believer, they're like that. They're supposed to be like that. فَهُمْ إِخْوَةٌ. And they are brothers, as Allah said in Surah Al-Hujurat, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ, that the believers are brothers. إخوة في الإيمان ولا في النسب. لا في النسب. He said they are brothers in إيمان. They are brothers in إيمان, not in lineage, but they are brothers in إيمان. وقوله وذبائحهم ذبيحة المسلم حلال. And also the statement of the author رحمه الله, and also their sacrificial animal, if they slaughter goat, lamb, cow, a chicken, Muslim, then their dabiha is halal. Whatever they slaughter is halal. حتى لو كان فاسقا, even if he was disobedient, if he was a sinner, even if he was a sinner, ما دام أنه لم يخرج من الإسلام فدبيحته حلال. As long as he does not exit the fold of Islam, his dabiha is halal. Whatever he slaughters is halal, even if he was fasiq, he drinks alcohol or something like that, but he's a believer. He believes on Allah, he prays five times a day and the like, and he slaughtered an animal, then we accept that and we eat it. طيب. والمنافق أيضا إذا ذبح ذبيحة نأكلها بحكم أنه مسلم. He said likewise the hypocrite. Because the hypocrite is not going to say, well, you know what, I tricked you, I said that I manifested Islam, but I'm a disbeliever. He's not going to say that. Because the hypocrite, he's going to hide the kufr in his heart. وَلْحِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. And he manifested Islam. Now let's say this hypocrite, we don't know his condition. He slaughtered an animal. The sheikh, he said, you can eat there his meat. You can eat the sacrificial animal, because we don't know the reality about this man. We don't know. So apparently he's a Muslim. So if he slaughtered an animal, we eat that food, we eat that meat. ما لم يتبين لنا أنه منافق. As long as we don't know, and it's not clear to us that he's a hypocrite. قال تعالى إلا ما دكيتم. هذا خطاب للمسلمين. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, do not eat except that which you have. Dakkaytum means you said Bismillah before you start slaughtering. You mentioned the name of Allah on it. He said, and this address is for the Muslims. وَأَبَاحَ لَنَا دَبَائِحَ لِلْكِتَابِ. And he also deemed permissible for us the sacrificial animal slaughtered by the people of the book, Christian or Jews. So if they slaughter cow, goat, anything, then it is halal for us. As Allah has mentioned here, Sheikh is going to mention Surah Al-Ma'idah. Surah Al-Ma'idah. وَطَعَامُ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابِ حِلُّ لَكُمْ. And the food of the people of the book who were given scripture is halal for you. Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, the food here means the slaughtered animal. The animal that they slaughter. Cow, chicken, goat, lamb, anything like that. يعني دبائحهم. Meaning their slaughtered animal. لأنهم يذبحون على الطريقة الشرعية بموجب ما عندهم من الكتاب. Because they slaughter according to the legislative method, according to what they have in their book. أما ذبائح الوثنيين والكفار والدهريين والمرتدين فنحن لا نأكلها. As far as the slaughtered animal that was slaughtered by الوثنيين. الوثنيين are the idol worshippers. Idol worshippers, those who worship idols. والكفار, the disbelievers, والدهريين. الدهريين comes from الدهر. الدهر is time. And الدهريين are those individuals that say, they believe that nothing will happen after they die. So الدهريين, basically they don't believe in the resurrection and the like. So they are kuffar. If they said only the time is going to pass, we will die and nothing's going to happen. These are dahriyin. So if they slaughter, basically atheists, they're atheists. So these atheists, if they slaughter an animal, we don't eat from it. We don't eat from it. والمرتدين, المرتدين are those who used to be Muslim and they apostated. They left Islam, والعياذ بالله. They apostated. those we don't eat their meat. لأنها دبيحة كافر وهي نجسة. Because this will be a slaughtered animal that was slaughtered by a disbeliever. And it is impure. نجسة. Impure. لأن دبيحة الكافر ميتة. نجسة بالكفر. He said, because the slaughtered animal of the disbeliever is considered dead meat. It's considered dead meat. Because it is stained. It is stained by his blasphemy. Stained by his blasphemy. لأنها تتأثر بالدابح فتكون خبيثة لأن دابحها خبيث. Because the slaughtered animal is influenced by the one who slaughters it, and the one who slaughtered it is a disbeliever, is a wicked disbeliever, then this slaughtered animal will be like filthy, will be filthy. You don't eat it. Will be filthy and wicked. طيب. وكون الله جل وعلا أباح لنا ذبائح على الكتاب خاصة دليل على تحريم ذبائح غيرهم. He said, and the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deemed the slaughtered animal of the people of the book halal for us, this would necessitate that other than them, from al-kuffar, then their dabaih, their slaughtered animal, is not permissible. Like Hindu, Buddhist, and other than them. We don't eat their slaughtered animal, or the idol worshippers, like the Hindus, those who worship, they worship Vishnu and Lakshmi, and other than that, from the so-called Hindu god, false Hindu god, and the like. وقوله والصلاة عليهم, and the statement of the author, and to perform janaza on them. يصلى على كل مسلم. He said, janaza is to be performed upon every Muslim. حتى لو كان فاسقا وعاصيا أو منافقا لم يظهر نفاقه ما دام أنه لم يخرج من الإسلام. He said, صلاة الجنازة, janaza prayer, is to be performed upon every Muslim, whether he is a sinner, or he is disobedient, or he is a munafiq, as long as we don't know his condition. As long as we don't know his condition, and he did not exit the fold of Islam. فَإِنَّهُ يُصَلَّ عَلَيْهِ, this person would perform janaza on him. وَيُدْعَى لَهُ, and we make dua for him. وَيُسْتَغْفَرُ لَهُ, and we seek forgiveness for him. وَيَرِثُ قَرِيبَهُ الْمُسْلِمُ, and he can also inherit, or vice versa. وَيَرِثُهُ قَرِينُهُ قَرِيبُهُ الْمُسْلِمُ, and also his relative, his Muslim relative, can inherit from him. وَقَوْلُهُ وَلَا نَشْهَدُ لِأَحَدٍ بِحَقِيقَةِ الْإِيمَانِ حَتَّى يَأْتِ بِجَمِيعِ شَرَائِعِ الْإِسْلَامِ. And the statement of the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, and we don't witness to anyone that he has the reality of iman until he fulfills all the legislation of Islam. Until he fulfills all the legislation of Islam. أي لا نزكي أحدا بأن نقول فلان مؤمن. So this means that we don't praise anyone to say that he is a complete believer. لأن الشهادة له بأنه مؤمن شهادة قد لا يستحقها. قد لا يستحقها. He said, because this testimony or this testification that this person is a complete believer, he may not deserve it. He may not deserve it. ولهذا لما قال رجل للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أعطي فلان فإنه مؤمن. And that's why when a man said to the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, give person so and so, because he's a believer. قال أو مسلم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, or Muslim. ثم قال نعم. ثم قال اعطي فلانا فإنه مؤمن. And then he said, give this person so and so because he's a believer. So Prophet ﷺ, he said, or a Muslim. فالنبي يريد بهذا أن الإنسان لا يزكي أحدا إنما يعطيه الاسم العام. He said, the Prophet ﷺ, he intended by this that we don't praise anyone, we don't say he's a complete believer and so on and so forth, but we give him the general name, which is he's Muslim. He is a Muslim. General name, الاسم العام. فيقول هو مسلم قد يكون مسلما متمكنا من الإسلام. So we say he's a Muslim. He might be a Muslim who is well established in Islam. وقد يكون مسلما عنده فسق. And he may be a Muslim, but he has disobedience with him. He has disobedience with him. وعنده معاصي ونقص. And he has sins and deficiency. وقد يكون منافقا. And he may be a hypocrite. فلا نشهد له بالكمال. We don't witness that he is a complete believer. Inshallah, we're going to stop right here. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficent knowledge and righteous action. Walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Anyone has a question? Nah, tafaddal. You have a question? Oh, okay. Well, yeah. The innovator, as long as his innovation does not take him out of the fold of Islam, Salat al-Janazah is due on him. Because the innovation is two types. Ulama, they mention, for example, you can pray behind an innovator. If you can't find someone from the people of the Sunnah, like for example, you have one masjid in the area where you are, and in order to go to the other masjid where people are from the people of the Sunnah is too far, and it becomes a hardship on you. So in that case, you go to that masjid where the imam might be an innovator, but his innovation does not take him out of the fold of Islam. He doesn't have anything that takes him out of the fold of Islam. But he has some innovations, right? But they don't take him out of the fold of Islam. You pray behind them. And the prayer behind him is valid. Prayer behind him is valid. Likewise, the innovator, Salat al-Janazah, can be performed on him. As long as innovation does not take him out of the fold of Islam. But if his innovation takes him out of the fold of Islam, then we don't perform Salat Janazah on him. Because he's a kafir. Like those that believe in al-hulul, they believe that Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inside them. Like al-Hallaj, he said, Ana huwa wa huwa ana. He said, I am Allah and Allah is me. It's kufr. This is kufr. Yeah. So somebody like that, we don't pray, perform Salat Janazah on him. If he dies upon that belief, or any nullifier of Islam, but someone who has a minor innovation, because there is minor and major, minor does not take him out. But major innovation takes him out. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficent knowledge and righteous action. Walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.